To understand effect of stress and strain on any material, like the materials used in a bridge, we need to plot stress-strain diagram. Stress-strain diagram is a graph that represents the behavior of a material under an increasing load condition. A stress-strain diagram contains three zones: elastic deformation zone, plastic deformation zone, and rupture. Elastic deformation zone. In this zone, material returns to its original dimensions on releasing the applied load. Plastic deformation zone. In this zone, the material endures some permanent deformation that remains on releasing the load. Rupture. Rupture is a point at which a material breaks or fails. Proportional limit. Look at the stress-strain diagram. Stress and strain diagram is a straight line from point O to point P and is in proportional limit. This linear relation was first noticed by Sir Robert Hooke in 1678 and is called Hooke's law, which states that the stress is directly proportional to the strain, or sigma equal to E epsilon, where E, that is modulus of elasticity, is equal to the slope of the stress and strain diagram from point O to point P. Yield point. Yield point is the point at which the material will have an appreciable elongation or yielding without any further increase in load. Ultimate strength. The maximum ordinate point value in the stress-strain diagram is the ultimate strength or tensile strength. Rupture strength. Rupture strength is the strength of the material at rupture. This is also known as the breaking strength. Resilience. The resilience of the material is its ability to absorb energy without creating a permanent distortion. Modulus of resilience is the work done on a unit volume of material as the force is gradually increased from O to P in Newton meter per meter cube. This is calculated as the area under the stress-strain diagram from the origin O to the elastic limit E. Toughness. The toughness of a material is its ability to absorb energy without causing it to break. Modulus of toughness is the work done on a unit volume of material as the force is gradually increased from O to R in Newton meter per meter cube. This is calculated as the area under the entire stress-strain diagram from O to R. Let us now perform an experiment to understand stress and strain diagram more clearly. Let us apply the tensile load on a shaft made of mild steel whose diameter is 14 mm and length 50 mm. We will be applying load on this shaft till it breaks. When a load is applied on the shaft, it elongates to some extent. We need to note down the readings for load and elongation. To apply the load, we need to press the green button. When we press the green button, we get the readings for load and elongation. To note the next reading, we need to keep pressing the green button again and again till the shaft breaks. The sheet displayed on the screen shows the different readings for load and elongation.